Who let you sleep, man? Now tell me about no hard luck. Come on, fatty, just sleep that. Let the man come dig ground with me. Today we sow, tomorrow we reap. Then everything will be sweet, sweet, sweet. Corn and yam, banana too. And our livestock won't be few. Give them a dreadlock. Give them a ballet. Yeah. Give them a screw fest. Don't let them come. Don't let them run. Don't let them come.
Come down, come down, come down, come down. Have you pumped and cried? Good morning. Are you hearing me? Please give me some indication that you're hearing me, Curly. Are you hearing me? Okay, we are ready to commence our morning's cultural activities and devotional exercise. All right, another Wednesday morning, second Wednesday morning, we are here again, and we are grateful unto God for his mercies towards us. All right. As some of you may know, my name is Yvette Fraser. I am the cultural coordinator. And so this morning, I will start off the devotional activities as we focus on you, our children, through whom the culture and the traditions can be channeled. All right? And the main purpose also for us gathering here in this fashion is to preserve the Jamaican cultural heritage. All right, so when we talk about our culture, we are talking about everything that we do at school, at home, in our community, all the practices, all the customs, all of that would engulf our culture. And we want to engender a greater sense of civic pride in you children. Actually, we want to create a greater awareness and appreciation for our cultural heritage. All right, all the practices and all the things that have been handed down from our foreparents. We encourage you to look at those things and to cherish them, because they are going to be of very importance to us. And we want to cherish our roots, all the nation builders, all our heroes who have worked very hard to create this great, rich legacy for us. And also we want to observe all the protocols as it relates to our national anthem, our pledge, and so forth. All right, boys and girls. So good morning, students. Good morning, teachers, parents, and all our friends that are with us this morning. All right, we are going to go right ahead in our activities as we have a limited time and we want to go through as quickly as possible. All right, so this morning we want to let you know that we will be focusing on our motto. And as you would have known, we have dealt with all these aspects of our culture before, our national symbols and emblems. You know that our motto is out of many, one people. Everybody remember that? Out of many, one people. So this morning we seek to advise you of the meaning of this motto, because this motto is very important to us and it is very significant and plays a great part in us as in our lives as Jamaicans. All right. And it also depicts nationhood, citizenships. All right. All the persons who are citizens of Jamaica, we want you to be proud of your identity. All right. Who you are as a Jamaican. Okay. So this morning we are going to be focusing on that. All right. And so we will have two presentations, and the presentations will highlight the coat of arms, which has the Jamaican motto on it, and we will also look at our own school's motto. All right, so let's begin, and we will sing the song, Jamaica Land of Beauty. All right, I know you're unable to unmute, however, I'm expecting everyone, please, to join in and sing with us as we sing this patriotic song, Jamaica Land of Beauty. Okay. Thank you very much. Wonderful rendition of the song Jamaica Land of Beauty. Now, children, although we are online because of the COVID restrictions, we're still going to expect you to show proper respect when we repeat our national pledge. All right. So I'm going to ask everyone, please, to stand and show proper respect as we recite the national pledge. All right, I will have to sit because I will have to assist in guiding you. Let's begin. Before God and all mankind, I pledge the love and loyalty of my heart, the wisdom and courage of my mind, the strength and vigor of my body in the service of my fellow citizens. I promise to stand up for justice, brotherhood, and peace, to work diligently and creatively, to think generously and honestly, so that Jamaica may, under God, increase in beauty, fellowship, and prosperity, and play her part in advancing the welfare of the whole human race. Okay, you may be seated. Thank you. Boys and girls, we're expecting you to be obedient and to respect our symbols. Okay, Matthew, please sit properly. Matthew Hibbert, thank you. Nice. All right. Now we will continue with the song, I Pledge, the Jamaica National School song, I Pledge My Heart Forever. Thank you. Boys and girls, and now I'm going to ask everyone to be very reverent as we do the national prayer. I'm going to ask Carissa Stewart and Katiana Stewart, please, to lead us off. Come on, boys and girls, I'm asking you to be very reverent. Carissa Stewart and Katiani Stewart. Begin, please, Carissa.
Good morning. Hold on, I'm going to un- okay.
Good morning, everyone.
Let us pray. Let us give thanks for all God's goodness and the wonderful heritage into which we have entered. For Jamaica or island home, the land of my birth.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For the majesty of our hills, the beauty of our valleys, and the flaming lovelands of our gardens.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For the warmth and brightness of our days, and the calm and peace of our countryside.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For the rich heritage of our people coming from many races and yet one in purpose, in achievement and in destiny, and for the dignity of labor and the service given by every citizen of our land.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For freedom, just laws, and our democratic way of life.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For the high privilege and responsibility of independence and for bringing us to nationhood.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For our parents, teachers, religious and other leaders, and all those who in every walk of life are helping to prepare us for responsible citizenship and for all those who are volunteering service in the public.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For the poets, artists, and thinkers, and all who create in us the vision of a new and better society.
We give thee thanks, O God.
For our godly heritage, the example of Jesus Christ, and the sacrifices of our fathers in the faith.
We give thee thanks, O God.
You will now respond by saying, hear us, we beseech thee, O God. Bless, we pray thee, our Queen, our Governor General, our Prime Minister, and other ministers of state, our Parliament, and all who are sent in authority over us, and grant that under them may be peacefully, we may be peacefully governed, peacefully and justly governed.
Hear us, we beseech thee, O God.
Grant us love and compassion for all those in need and distress, and help us to remove poverty and ignorance from our land, and grant us prosperity and true wisdom, we pray.
Hear us, we beseech thee, O God.
Forgive us all that is unworthy and evil in our nation life. Establish us in righteousness and inspire us to work for universal brotherhood, we pray.
Hear us, we beseech thee, O God.
Guide and bless our nation, we pray, and make us loyal and dutiful citizens through Almighty God, the Father of all of us all.
Amen. Thank you very much, ladies. Thank you very much, girls. Thank you very much for such excellence in praying for our nation. Okay, as we move along, we are now going to have our feature presentation. And this presentation will be on Jamaica Coat of Arms, as I said before earlier on in the introduction. So we're going to have that presentation now. Thank you.
During the period leading up to independence, the leaders of the country agreed in principle that the coat of arms is of significance to the nation and should remain a part of our history. The original arms were designed in 1961 by William Sandcroft, then Archbishop of Canterbury. He used the royal helmet and mantling together in the design. This is considered a unique distinction accorded Jamaica. The coat of arms show a male and female Taino, Arawak, standing on either side of the shield, which bears a red cross with five golden pineapples superimposed on it. The crest is a Jamaican crocodile surmounting the royal helmet and mantling of the British monarchy. The original Latin motto, Indus Iuturque Serviet Uni, has been changed to mean in English, out of many, one people. This motto reflects the multiracial nature of our population. The coat of arms is an official government symbol and can be found on the letterheads of government ministries and in some government buildings.
Okay, thank you very much, team, for presenting that wonderful historical idea of our nationhood. All right, if you notice, the video presented some valuable information about our history, all right, from the time we gained independence in 1962 until now. And it spoke about the coat of arms and all its important features. So as we go along today, we will learn more of the features. We are going to feature one of the significant aspects of our coat of arms. And I want you boys and girls to be very, very attentive as we make these presentations, because in the future, we are going to be having quizzes and you are going to be winning a lot of prizes, all right? So we want you to take your notes in the mornings where we have our national devotions. Take your notes, all right? And be very attentive to the information that we present, because we want you to learn, all right? And now we will have an item which will be done by Praise Marie Cohen. Actually, the name of the item is I Rise, and it's a medley.
I was made for this. See, I met so many hard times when I thought I could make it. See, I've had my trials when my pillow shone eyes. Then the morning came and my wings took flight. Brave.
Okay, thank you. Put your hands together for Praise Marie. Come on, show some love to Praise. Yeah, it's our own Praise Marie Cohen, a grade six student of our school. Actually, the performance that she has done was one of the JCDC item, musical item. And we want you boys and girls also to be involved in our JCDC performances. All right, so we have the JCDC competition in speech, music, and dance coming up. Boys and girls, I want you to be a part of those clubs. All right, as soon as we give you the green light, and we want to unearth your talents. All right, let me see all those who can sing. Raise your hand if you can sing. Come on, show me the emojis. Come on. If you can sing, show your hand. All right, so I want you to contact Mr. Dixon. Let me see all the persons who can speak nicely, like Carissa and Katiani, those who can speak nicely. Right, please contact me. Those who can dance, all those who can do the dinky mini, the quadrille, the maypole, and all those traditional dances, please contact Mrs. Calvin Williams. All right, we want you to get involved in these cultural activities because remember, you are the channel through which our cultural heritage is going to continue from one generation to another. All right, boys and girls, and now at this time, we're going to have a presentation which will be done by Jacqueline Henry on the Jamaica's motto. All right, so please, as I said before, please get your pens and your pencils, jot down your notes, because you're going to need this information. All right, Miss Henry, are you seeing my screen?
Yes, but I'm not seeing it so clearly though. Can you move to the next slide? Okay. Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning, parents. Good morning, colleagues. As was said earlier, we are going to feature one of our national, if I should say emblem, our national motto. Now, what is a motto? A motto is a short sentence or phrase meant to formally describe the general, brief motivation or intention of an individual, family, school, social group, or organization. They are normally short and easy to remember. The most important of all is have some relationship to the person, product, or name. Next. Next slide.
Just a minute, Miss Henry.
Okay. Okay, as you can see here, our motto is out of many, one people. Next slide. The Jamaican national motto is out of many, one people, based on the population's multicultural roots. The motto is represented on the coat of arms, showing a male, a female member of the Taino tribe standing on either side of a shield which bears a red cross and five golden pineapples. The crest shows a Jamaican crocodile mounted on the royal helmet of the British monarchy and mantling. Next slide. The nation's motto was announced on April 3, 1962, on the authority of the Premier Norman Washington Manley and Cabinet Leader of the Opposition, Sir Alexander Bustamante. Out of many one people replaced the Latin motto, Indus Autecur Servet Uni, the Indians twain shall serve one Lord, which was discarded as bearing no relation to the modern independent Jamaica. The motto is inscribed on the scroll of the Jamaican coat of arms, which was retained without any alteration. It reflects diversity of the Jamaican people, being a mix of different races, cultures, and religion. However, the national motto was created because the leadership of the new independent Jamaica and colonists happily vacating the country wanted to, first, assure the wealthy and potential foreign investors that they had no need to fear the desperately poor Black masses. Second, it sought to convince the poor Black people that those with wealth were their genuine brothers and sisters. This was intended to head off the violent expressions of the ever-present class struggle and any flirtation with communism. Now, the Anchovy Primary School also has a motto, hard work, key to success. This means becoming successful in life is totally dependent on how hard one is willing to work. The school's motto was recently changed to aspire, believe, and conquer. What does that mean? Aspire to direct one's hope or ambition towards achieving something. Believe, to have faith, confidence in yourselves. Conquer, to overcome obstacles and reaching your goals. I hope you learned something. Thank you for listening. Back over to Mrs. Fraser.
Thank you, Ms. Henry, Ms. Jacqueline Henry, for such a wonderful presentation. Thank you so very much for your kind assistance in helping us to understand more about our culture. All right, boys and girls, remember, we are from different ethnic groups. And even though we are from different ethnic groups, Africans and Europeans and so forth, we Indians, Chinese, we are one race. All right, we have a rich culture, a melting pot of different cultures and practices, but we are still one. Some brown, some have long hair, some have short hair, some have blue eyes, some have black eyes, some have brown eyes. However, we are still one Jamaica, one Jamaican. We little, but we talawa. We little, everybody say that. I know you can't on me, but say that. We little, but we talawa. Greatest people on earth, all right? And so at this time, without any further delay, we are going to move on, all right, to singing our school's anthem, We Aspire, We Believe.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, boys and girls, for tuning in to this morning's cultural explosion. All right, and now we will have our school's creed, and it's going to be done by Katiana Stewart. I'll now invite Katiana Stewart to present to us. Thank you. Katiani, are you there? Katiani Stewart?
Teacher.
Okay, go ahead, my
dear. Yes, teacher, I'm here.
Yes, my dear.
Okay, teacher. This is the school's creed. I am an Anchovy Primary School student. I have great expectations for myself. I have the power to be a better person. Hence, I accept the challenge to become the best that I can be. Yesterday's failures are behind me. Today's successes are now before me. I will make today the very best day of all. For this day begins the rest of my life. I accept the responsibilities for my behavior and its results. I will show respect for the environment. I do not have the right to interfere with the learning and well-being of others. With my family and teachers, I will determine what I will become. For the education I receive today will make me a leader of tomorrow. I have the power, I will succeed.
Thank you very much, Katiani. Now, boys and girls, we are expecting you to learn the school's creed, to learn the national anthem, to learn the national pledge. You are to learn all of these. I'm sure our teachers have posted them in the classrooms. So I'm expecting you boys and girls to learn them, all right? They are a part of our culture, and it's all the message in these pieces that we present to you, whether it's on a school basis or it's a national basis, we expect you to internalize the words and the messages from these, okay? So please go in your Google Classrooms and study these. Study the creed, anthem, the pledge, and so forth, so that you know them. So when I call on you, you won't have to read anything. You're able to recite from your memory. All right, boys and girls, promise me you're gonna do that? Yes, I know you're going to say yes. All right, thank you very much. And now we will culminate by having our national anthem. Come on, boys and girls, I'm expecting you to stand at attention. Let us not start as yet. Hold on, technology team, hold on a moment, please. And boys and girls, stand at attention. Boys and girls, I'm expecting all of you to respect your national symbols, okay? And this is very important for your growth and development, all right, as a citizen, all right? So please, everybody, stand at attention. Stand, hold up your head high, place your hand at your side, and be still. Stop what you are doing. The protocol is you stop what you're doing, and you show proper respect towards our symbols. Very important, boys and girls. Okay, thank you, technology team. Thank you. Please go ahead now.
Eternal Father. guide us with thy mighty hand. Keep us free from evil powers. Be our life through countless hours. To our leaders, great defenders, grant true wisdom from above. Justice fruit be ours forever, to make a land we love. Jamaica, 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 land we love. Teach us true respect.
Okay, thank you so much, boys and girls, teachers, parents, and all our well-wishers for tuning in this morning and watching all the information and participating as well in the cultural activities that we engaged in this morning. All right, we are so grateful for this opportunity. Although we have the limitations, we are still not going to allow that to stop us from doing what we have to do. All right, boys and girls, just bear in mind that next month is going to be a special time for us when we acknowledge our heritage. It's Heritage Month. And so you will hear of some of the activities that will take place. And we also have a club, a boys club coming up on stream. Boys, we have you in mind. Therefore, we are expecting all our boys to participate as the time comes and we continue to embrace our cultural heritage. All right, boys and girls, thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, technology team. Thank you, culture team. Thank you, everyone. I'll now invite Mrs. Mitchell, is she here, our principal, to address us. Mrs. Mitchell, are you there? Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Mrs. Fraser.
You are welcome, Miss.
Good morning, everyone. It is another beautiful day that the Lord has afforded us with. A day to give thanks. A day that we've not ever seen before and one we'll never see again. And as such, we give thanks to God for his loving kindness, his keeping care, his tender mercies toward. It is indeed a great privilege to be able to get over 400 of you online on a given morning to give thanks to God and to
you are on mute, Miss.
And to the technology team, did you not hear anything at all that I said?
No, parts were out.
Okay, let me say good morning again and say thanks to all of you who joined this morning. I was saying that it is a privilege to be able to have over 400 persons online giving homage to our national symbols, giving thanks to God. who is continuously Yes, I want to apologize. The phone rings continuously, and each time the phone rings, I get bumped out of the meeting. But I just want to say thanks to you all. We started our devotions at 9 this week and last week, but come next week, our devotions will begin at 8 o'clock, and devotions will run between 8 and 8:30 a.m. for us to get enough time to get online in our classes and to maximize whatever time we have for learning. We will share your calendar of events today, so you will see what we will do moving forward. Thanks again to the technology team. Thanks to Mrs. Fraser for taking up the challenge, the cultural team in executing these national devotions. It is just an exciting feeling to hear, especially the school emblems being expressed in this virtual space. And it brings a sense of pride, a sense of national and school pride, to be able to recite our national anthem or national pledge, the prayer, as well as our school's symbols. As Mrs. Fraser was saying, ensure that you learn the symbols, the creed. Your teachers would have posted those in your classrooms. The anthem would have been posted, but most of you would have been reciting over the years, especially for the upper school children, because we do not want you to lose sight of what we do here. So we have brought our programs online. God bless you. Have yourselves a wonderful day. Now go to class. Most of you are still doing diagnostic assessments. Grade 6 will be doing science this morning, and you will be doing more than like language arts later on. Social studies will be done tomorrow, and mathematics will be done tomorrow also. Ensure that you try your best to do well on the exams. However, what you do will just give us an opportunity to decide how we deal with you and where we start with you. Have yourselves a blessed day. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Mitchell. Thank you, boys and girls, teachers, parents, friends. Thank you all. Okay, please disconnect your system now and go to your classes, please. All right.
They bring back color TV, some bring Volvo and the video. Jamaica, I never leave you again. I mean it.